They are demanding a dignified life, a future for their children. Palestinian refugees have been gathering outside Western embassies in the Lebanese capital, Beirut, demanding humanitarian asylum.
Give us opportunities to live. We want to be productive. We want to go to Europe to work and give our children an education.
Palestinians are criticizing a recent Lebanese government crackdown on undocumented foreign labor. As refugees, they believe they should be exempt. Lebanese law already bans them from working in many professions and denies them access to public services as part of a long-standing policy to discourage them from staying.
If we are denied the right to work and open businesses, then how do we pay for medical treatment, for example? UNRWA says it covers 100% of the cost, but that is not true. It paid only 10% of my father's operation. He was a cancer patient, and he has since passed away.
International aid for Palestinian refugees has decreased in recent years. The UN Relief and Works Agency, UNRWA, which supports Palestinian refugees, says it is providing services to all of them, but it needs $120 million to be able to fund operations until the end of the year.
Palestinians have been living here for more than 70 years since the creation of Israel, but now their situation is getting worse. Unemployment was already a problem before the recent decision by Lebanese authorities that requires them to obtain work permits.
Permits are not only expensive, but they are also difficult to get. Palestinians who owned shops like Zakaria Nassar were also affected by the government crackdown. This 27-year-old lost his livelihood in a country going through a severe economic crisis.
They told me I have no right because I'm a Palestinian. We really are suffering. Many of us are graduates, but what is the use of educating your children when they are not allowed to work?
There is anger and resentment among the almost 200,000 refugees. They say they should be given special status and not be treated as foreign workers. But many have lost hope in their host country and are looking for a better life outside Lebanon. Zeina, Khodr, Al Jazeera, Beirut.